I have found the quilting community to be very generous, both with their time, knowledge, skills, and of course their finished products. In today's video, I want to share some tips for charity quilting, things to think about when you are planning to donate a quilt.
I'm Andy, and this is True Blue Quilts, a place to enjoy, experiment, and excel as you quilt.
For me, I had to start donating my finished quilts. I've covered every bed, every couch, and every person in my family with multiple quilts. So where do you start to find a suitable charity if you are thinking about donating a quilt? Well, there are some national organizations. Things like Project Linus and Quilts of Valor are good places to start. Be sure to check their websites for size requirements. Project Linus is geared towards children's quilts, so they will be looking for smaller projects. Quilts of Valor honors our veterans and service members, so you're thinking of adults, men that may be taller, so their requirements can accommodate larger size projects. If you are looking for a charity close to home, just do a quick Google search, donate quilts near me, and you'll come up with lots of resources. And many guilds do community service projects. So they may be supporting child protection services, senior centers, and animal rescue groups. Whatever your interest is, there is an organization out there that can use your quilting talents. Now that you have an idea of who you will be making a quilt for, it's time to think about what you will be making. Of course, it's a quilt. But quilts come in many different sizes and styles, and you really want to match your product to the needs of the organization. If it's for a child, you probably don't want a lot of embellishments or things that could pose a safety hazard. And you don't know the environment that this quilt will be going into. You want it to be beautiful and useful. So don't put too much stress on yourself for using some overly complicated pattern. Simple can truly be beautiful. How you quilt for charity is going to be your personal choice. Making something as an anonymous donor can give you a huge sense of freedom. Those seams don't have to match as perfectly as they would for a show quilt going to a juried exhibit. Charity quilts can be a great place to experiment and try new techniques that you have not perfected yet, and maybe experiment with some unusual color combinations, that fabric that you're wondering, why did I ever buy that? I'll never use that in my home. But you can pair it with some lovely coordinates and someone will treasure it. I've also talked to a lot of long arm quilters that use charity quilts as a place to perfect their craft. And those practice pieces are just wonderful for the many organizations out there that could use a touch of handmade love. I came up with a few more recommendations to keep in mind when you are quilting for charity. Remember that your project will probably be thrown in the washing machine and dryer, so keep that in mind when you're choosing your batting and your quilting style. You want this project to hold up. Make sure the binding is secure. Sometimes a machine binding on both sides will hold up a little better than spending the time and effort to hand stitch the whole binding down. Because you don't know the ultimate recipient of a donation quilt, it's best to keep things gender neutral. So I mentioned Quilts of Valor. They do accept all color combinations, but they find the most popular for veterans is a patriotic color scheme. Very simple to use those red, white, blue, and touches of gold and yellow in your design. A final reminder to always wash your quilt before you donate it. It makes sure there's no surprises down the line. It makes sure your quilt is fresh and clean and ready for a new home. I hope these tips help you along the way to making a quilt for donation and that you are able to make at least one project to donate this year. If you're looking for a way to use up a lot of your scraps, try this split 9-patch pattern. This video shows you how to make this fun quilt block and even includes a variety of layout options for you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.